Hello friends, and in this video I'll be helping with how to find interquartile range. So let's start. So it's very easy. If you know the concept, you can solve it within few minutes. Okay, so you'll be provided like this kind of data. Okay, this is the data set you'll be provided with, and you will be asked to find the interquartile range. So how you can find? So let's try it out. The first step is you need to write the data set in a sorted manner from smaller to the larger one. So let's write down. So first will be 3, then 5, then 5, then 7, and then 8, 9, then 10, 13, 14, 15, 16, 22 and 23. All right, so we have just written the data set in a sorted manner from smaller one to the larger one. Okay, that is all right. Then what you need to do is you need to count the number of data points you have. That is 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 13 14 15. We have 15, right? That is an odd number. If you have an even number, then you need to directly divide your data set into half and then calculate the lower half mean and the upper half mean. But because this is odd, you need to find the mean like this, the middle element in your data set. All right, our mean will be 10. Okay, and you will divide the data set from here. You will not include this 10. But if the number was even, then you would have included this 10 also. Okay, so we'll find mean for this lower half and the upper half as well. So for the lower half, it will be 7. For the upper half, it will be 15. Okay, so it's quite easy. The process is very simple. Okay, in some books, it is written as Q1 and Q3. So you don't need to get confused. The process for calculating inner quartile range is subtracting the upper half mean from, sorry, subtracting the lower half mean from upper half mean, that is Q3 minus Q1. So your Q3 is 15 and your Q1 is 7. So your answer will be 8. So 8 is our inner quartile range. So this was all about how you can find. So if you like the video, please do hit the like button, do consider subscribing, and thanks for watching.